All right, let's round out the Summoner's Trilogy with the last book of the series, Battle Mage, or the Battle Mage, however you want to say it. So, for those of you who remember the end of the last book, which I don't blame you if you don't, because probably no one watched that video, no one's probably going to watch this one either, but still. At the end of the last book, Fletcher and friends were caught behind enemy lines after their rescue mission to save a captive held by the orcs. They originally believed that captive was someone else of high importance, but as it turns out, it's actually Fletcher's birth mother, who's been held captive by the orcs since she was captured back when he was an infant, so over a decade. And so because of that, she has a lot of damage. Anyway, because they're stuck behind enemy lines, pinned down, and have no other choice, they escape into the ether, which, if you don't remember, is that other dimension where demons originate from. And they're forced to find their way through this hell dimension, not literally hell, but pretty close if you're not a demon, in order to try to make it back to their own side to escape. And it's a interesting chase, interesting concept, because all the while behind them, the orcs are, well, chasing them in order to finish them and question them about the salamander or Ignatius. Of course, they have a big fight around the volcano, and Ignatius evolves into a more dragon-like form in the form of a drake. And because this is only the first part of the book, they actually manage to escape fairly early. And when they make it back to the school, which I don't remember if they're graduates from or not, I know they went to war in the last book, so I'm assuming that means they graduated. They find out that the old man Forsythe, as I call him, because I can't pronounce his first name that easily, he is, for those of you who don't remember, he's the father of those two asshole noble twins from book one and also book two, and has basically been the pain in everyone's side since book one. Anyway, he's gone and framed them for murder. Because why not add another thing to be an asshole about? Yeah, he's framed them for murder. And on top of that, the kingdom has actually managed to invent, with magic, a radio system, or at least a public broadcasting system that's basically radio. And the king is using it to broadcast racist hate speech across the kingdom almost every day. That feels pretty fucking topical at times, don't it? Yeah, with the combination of those two things, racial tension is at an all-time high. And the gang has to avoid all of this to try to go into hiding to avoid the potential for execution and are getting wrapped up in more crazy shit. So having to prove their innocence and somehow deal with the rising racial tension, the group goes into hiding because the orcs are on their way and they don't have a lot of time to fool around. Now, this is the final book, and that was a basic summary of events. And while it does feel a bit scattered, it's even more scattered than the actual book, in all honesty. I like this book overall, but there's some things I dislike. First off, the Fletcher and Silva thing. So throughout this entire series, since book one, after they saved her life, there's been this kind of romantic tension between her and Fletcher, obviously. And obviously it was going to be paid off in this book, but it's actually not. Rather early on, Silva cuts off the romance because she says her people, the elves, can never accept a relationship between a human and an elf. Which seems kind of weird for a series that's about building up, trust and friendship and all this kind of stuff, and mutual bonds with the other races to fight against greater evil. That whole friendship stuff. But then says you can't go full romance because my neighbor wouldn't like it, or my people wouldn't like it. It feels kind of weird to suddenly have this thrust in there, especially in the last of book. Like, maybe if it came up in book two and they decided to say fuck it at the end of book three, but nope, they just kind of cut it here. It could have something to do with her being a royal, but it still feels really weird to just suddenly say, nope, we can't do romance anymore. We have to end it. And, well, honestly, let's talk about the orcs, because again, they feel a little weird in this book. They're only a major player in the beginning of the book, at the beginning of the story, and at the end of the story. All the middle stuff stuffed up with human drama and trying to consolidate forces and all that kind of stuff to fight them. So obviously we don't get a bit, we don't get that big of a sense of the orcs themselves. And as such, while we know they're a major threat, especially from the end of book two, they still feel like this nebulous force of evil as they did in book one. Like, again, maybe if they cut out the human drama and maybe made a fourth book that dealt mostly with the orc war, sort of like how they were setting up book two for its latter half to focus almost entirely on the orc war. But no, they have to deal with Old Man Forsythe and deal with him being a money-grubbing, well, human villain asshole. Speaking of human villains, look, to have a main villain who's solely motivated by greed is fine, but he's basically a side villain who's, you know, worked with the enemy, aka the thing that wants to eradicate its entire species, well, probably not worked with, but profited off of their, like, their attacks and even motivated several of their attacks to get maximum gains. And yeah, he feels cartoonishly evil, especially considering the fact he's literally telling Fletcher how he's partly responsible for the death of his father and the madness of his mother. And it feels weird to let him do that when there's someone else in the room who could go like, wait, you did that? Like, I know it's a stooge, but considering how massive of a thing the war with the orcs is, you'd think colluding with them or in any way, shape, or form would be considered a major war crime or gigantic ass you're gonna die kind of situation, especially considering how long this war's been going on for. I mean, not to make a comparison, but in the Disney movie Raya and the Last Dragon, everyone managed to toss their, like, differences aside in the force of the greater good of stopping the Droon, which was a nebulous force of evil that killed a lot of people. I imagine the orcs would be the same thing, and even the orc main villain, the Khan, or Orc Khan, feels more like a plot device to have a big bat to kill for the final fight that wasn't the human villain. Just to kind of end the orc war. He's not really all that fleshed out. I know he has something to do in the prequel, but I honestly, it's a prequel, so I don't have that much interest in it. And that's just a little bit of my issues with this book, but overall I do like it, but I don't feel this is an ending. It feels more like it's a bump in the road and there should be a fourth book on the way to deal with more of the issues. Because they kind of try to wrap up everything in a giant bow, but it feels unrealistic considering the racial tension that's a major plot point and background element to this world. They don't 100% deal with it, but they say, hey, everything's on the right path. But you really don't see that. I mean, they kind of end it. They get rid of the asshole old king and get rid of the rich asshole because the orcs are dealt with so now they can deal with their assholes. But society as a whole was barely changed. Remember, there were multiple times where our characters had to fight against random civilians because they were riled up in racist fury. Like, remember when Silva was almost executed by racist assholes? And the multiple times that dwarves were assaulted by random racist assholes? It feels like they would take a lot more to fight this. And also, you'd think that there would be a group of them that would branch off and basically become terrorists of their own right. But the series just kind of ends like, well, everything's going good, so maybe the world will change. Again, it feels like there's supposed to be a fourth book here that's supposed to wrap up this plot line and maybe deal with the series' major themes, but no. Of course, that could also be me reading way more into it than I'm actually supposed to. I'm fully saying I could be reading it, getting a different reading considering the fact that the show focused a lot on the racist plotline and less on the orc war. But hey, you know, it's an ending, and at least it gives Fletcher finally a little piece of happiness of mind. A little peace of mind and happiness, especially considering how the last two books ended for him. Oh boy, that was brutal. But overall, yeah, as I stated earlier, I came away really liking this book. It's a decent finale for the series, and the fact that I kind of believe there's potential and want a little bit more out of it could stand the reason that, hey, this book did something right. So, like I've been saying with the previous ones, If you want some pretty decent YA fantasy, then pick up the Summoners Trilogy. Although, and again, I don't think anyone's really going to watch this video, like I don't think anyone's going to watch the last ones either. So, till next time, to Noblin.